Hey guys, what's going on? Today we're going to be going over both the global and the JP side data downloads. Now, I didn't do an update last night purposely because I knew the global side was going to have an update. I'd rather do one encompassing video. So let's go ahead and talk about it. We're going to do the global side first, and then we're going to jump into the JP news. All right, so first off, shout out to the Reddit. Thank you for all the information, all the translations. The community is really great. If you aren't already over here, go ahead and check out the DBZ Dokkan Battle Reddit. Join up. They are an awesome site with a lot of great people in the community that help translate all the information and data mine all the information so that way we have it before it actually hits. So that way you know if you should save your stones or not, or what events you're going to want to run. Anyway. Let's go ahead and jump into it. First off, we had a huge global data download last night. So, I don't know why it says March 3rd, 2018, but it's available right now because it's currently March 15th. anyway, maybe it was because they were looking three, whatever. DBZ.space schedule. Look at it. We have various world tournament units. Intelligence, Jackie Chun. SR Ranfan, SR Yamcha, Intelligence, SSR TN, Agility, SSR, well, Agility Legendary Rare TN. So, we have an LRTN that's coming finally to global, so I will probably be participating in the next world tournament when it comes around. We also have the new Tapion event with the new Tapion units coming. That's the tech and physical Tapions, the agility Tapion Herudagon version. He is, I believe, the huge category leader, so that's going to be a thing. Great Saiyan 1 and 2, Kid Trunks, Legendary Goku. If you don't know what that is, that means it is the legendary Super Saiyan Goku, the legendary Goku, LR Goku card, and it's pretty cool. It's a pretty good card. I would really like to have it. But again, it's like one of those regular legendary units. They're very hard to pull. Don't go hunting for him. It looks like we also have the low-class warrior event coming, the Saiyan Saga Intelligence Raditz that's going to be here. So go ahead and grind that out when it becomes available. Again, guys, I will be doing full coverage of all this stuff when it becomes available on the global side. I'll just do one event after another and I'll just cover it, especially the cards. Like the cards that I'm mentioning here, they will each get their own full review and team building guide associated with them, or at least the best character linking buddies. Dokkanfest that are coming, that's been scheduled, is going to be Golden Frieza, Super Saiyan 3 Bardock, Tech Vegito Blue, and Strength Super Saiyan Rose Goku Black. Now, Golden Frieza is currently here. We're going to be talking about that in a minute. We're not going to do a full in-depth review of the banner, but it is the same thing that was on the JP side. Super Saiyan 3 Bardock is one of my favorites. I can't wait for him to come out, and this should be a dual Dokkanfest. We also have the new Rebirths, which is the physical Kami, Agility Kid Goku, Agility Super Saiyan 3 Goku, and Strength Super Saiyan 3 Vegeta. That's going to be awesome. That Strength Super Saiyan 3 Vegeta is actually super viable because he is such a good defensive and attacking unit. And the Agility Super Saiyan 3 Goku, I believe that is the Kid Goku, the Kid, old GT Kid Goku, that's getting that awakening. We also have new items, the Extreme Z Summoning Ticket, and Tapion's Flute, which we're going to talk about in a little bit. This is the... That's the ticket that what I'm talking about right now. We don't know what that is about right now. I think that's going to be something like from Pilaf's Trove, possibly. Or it's going to be something that's like... you get a certain number of tickets when the Extreme Z Awakening event is here, and you have a chance to pull on the banner. You can pull on the banner with a chance to get some of the featured units. We have the medals that are here too. We looks like we have all the Dokkanfest medals for all those. Tapion story events. So nothing really cool here, except for the Extreme Z Awakening for Goku. And oh, look at that. Actually, I didn't see this. We have the Extreme Z Awakening for Broly as well. So we might be getting Broly out of order. And I know the global side likes to do things a little bit out of order to say, hey, we're different. But that's awesome. So it looks like we have this available. Thank you to Wizard Gino. Resurrection F story event is going to be coming back, and then we have the new True Evil Resurrected from Hell Dokkan event, so that's going to be awesome. So we can go ahead and do that. Sorry if you heard some sound effects in the background. I'm autoing Bleach Brave Souls right now. We also have the summonings, Extreme Z summonings, unknown. We don't know what that is. I'm assuming that's something to do with the actual ticket that I just mentioned. And we have the Golden Angel Frieza banner, which looks like the SSR rates are 0.7%. No incentives for doing multis. And we are going to talk about the banner in a second. Also, there looks like there was a graphical glitch on the French side of the Golden Frieza banner. Unfortunately, it also looks like Bamco thought that it didn't require any type of compensation because it didn't affect gameplay. Meanwhile, they gave out a hell of a lot of stones. They reimbursed everyone's stones for a graphical problem on the JP side. Wow, Bamco. That's just so grimy. You know, I don't know what else to say about that. Anyway, we're just going to forget about that because we all want to talk about the banner, and I'd rather not dwell on negative news. So let's go over here. This is the current Golden Frieza banner. This is the JP side. So this is literally a mirror image of the JP side. So we don't have anything really to worry about over here. It looks like 0.83, 0.78. Yeah, so it's about 0.7 all around the board. So that's not horrible, actually, for this banner, just because it has some really damn good units on it. It has the obviously the Frieza. Kid Buu, I would like one more cube of him. I'm definitely going to be doing three multis with you guys at some point. That'll probably either go up later today or tomorrow, most likely tomorrow, because I'm probably going to do it right after this video anyway. Super Saiyan 3 Angel Goku, I would like bottom right 2-path unlocked. And the rest of these guys I can do without. This guy, this Golden Freeze, I already have maxed out. This guy, I don't need maxed out because he's a support unit. This guy, I don't need him, he's a support unit. He's already maxed out and I don't really want him at all. But that's about it, and it looks like we have regular units in here. It does look like that Beerus and the Vegeta's here. I know everyone loves this Vegeta. I'm a huge fan of him. I think he is such a good unit. I'm very glad that he finally got a really good unit for this game, good card for this game. And the 217s, I really want those. Anyway, overall, this is a decent banner. Golden Frieza is a really cool leader. He can be very useful. I'm not going to hunt for the guy, but I'll probably do three multis, like I said. For those of you who are thinking if you want to pull on this, well, look at the units that you have. If you the ones that you should look for, the best ones in the game right now for, well, in terms of this banner, is the Frieza, obviously, Goku, Intelligence Kid Buu, but you need to have Intelligence Kid Buu friends, and the physical Frieza. The physical Golden Frieza is awesome, but you have to have a physical Korra to go along with him, otherwise you're really never going to run him too often. Until maybe he gets an Extreme Z Awakening, then he'll probably be a lot better, because I could see his passive going to like 150% or something like that, or maybe it'll be ridiculous, like 170%. Regardless, this is a good banner. This is a really good banner, and these two are really good support units. So, I mean, and if you don't have this Frieza, he's a really good unit as a blocker. You know, so this banner is not horrible whatsoever. Anyway, I don't want to just sit on that too much. I'll probably do a full in-depth overview when I do the card review. New mission starting on the 15th, which is today. So it looks like we will be getting the Extreme Z Awakening, hopefully very soon. Beat stage 20 or higher with Resurrected Warrior category team for 1 stone. That's on Easy A, so that's Extreme Z Awakening. And 20 or higher with 2 minutes or 40 seconds for 2 stones. Beat stage 10 or higher with 2 minimum for 1 stone. Dokkan Awakening, the unit for Elder Kai medals. Z Awakening, 3 units for 5 North Kai medals. Z Awakening, 1 unit for Platinum Statue. And you get some dailies. 1 stone for clearing 3 stages. Clear stage 1 for 2 Sensus. Wow. Hercule Event for Z Sword. Nothing special, really. Well, I mean, I guess you get some stones. I guess the stones you can consider to be... those are pretty good. You always want to have the stones. Anyway, so we'll talk about that at another point. Also, we have the new Supreme Kai Trials, as I mentioned before. These are really for the Dokkan events, so I guess you can go... Actually, it's not. It looks like it's under Quest. Offense and Defense. It looks like we got some extra stuff coming in here, so that's going to be awesome to go ahead and do. You can get some more items. And that's it for the global side. So we're moving over to the JP side now. By the way, shout out to DBZ.Space. If I haven't shouted him out before, this is a really good website for all useful information about Dokkan Battle. So you can go in here, there's a little menu on the right hand side, and you go between the global and the JP side. Most people are either going to go under the summon section or the card section. When you go into the card section, you can look at the schedule for soon to be released units. As we see here, we're going to be talking about these. We will not be going all in depth with them, but we have some new Dokkan Awakens, which is super freaking, like, I'm super excited for. And we also have some new units that are going to be coming, so we're going to talk about all that in a minute. We have a new JP celebration that's coming out. Looks like it's going to be a Jiren and Ultra Instinct Goku event. I guess it's going to coincide with the global, Dragon Ball Super, which is happening right now. It looks like we should have the new episode this weekend, so I'm kind of excited about that. So it looks like this might go alongside with that, so that's going to be awesome. It looks like we also have the new Battlefield, and this is all the levels with all the information. Level 1, you go up against physical Ginyu. Bring Goku, Sentai team, sub lead equals strength, Easy A Gohan. Okay, I'm not going to go full in depth in this. Level 1 boss is going to be Agility, GA, Grade 8 Vegeta. Level 2-1 is Intelligence Bojack. level 2-2, Tech Super 13. I guess it's Android 13. Level 2 boss is Strength Broly. Level 3-1, Goku Black. It looks like he can seal. Level 3-2 is Physical Super Saiyan Blue Vegeta. And stage 3 boss is Agility Super Saiyan Blue Goku. So that's about it. There's a whole bunch of other information over here, so you can go ahead and check it out, or pause the video if you want to read the full thing. Over here now we have the JP database download. Now this is everything I just showed you before. Outside of these units, so I'm just going to go over in a little bit really quick, just because it's all in one place on the JP side. Unfortunately, the new stuff for the global side isn't available for viewing yet on DBZ.Space. So when it is, I'll end up coming back to it, obviously, and I'll end up doing a full review of all this. But we'll go ahead and we'll talk about that in a minute. Returning events, Super Saiyan 3 Goku, Extreme Z Awakening returns on 3:18 at 4 a.m. New celebration coming, unsure the details, but a few missions for it. Champa event returns, Champa. New missions, there's a ton of new missions. So we can go over here, look, it looks like new weekly missions that reset every Friday, gives 1 stone for spending 300 stamina. Clearing all missions, possibly stages of the new Tournament of Power, the opening stage event gives 3 stones. Clearing stage 2, 1, 3, 7, 10, and 15 times will reward 1 strength Caulifla each. So we're going to have that new event that's going to look like the Tournament of Power event. STR Caulifla does token awaken into a Super Saiyan, which we're going to talk about in a minute. She should be able to feed into her agility counterpart. In addition, clearing stage 7, 15, 20, and 30 times will reward 1 of each. Clearing stage 3, 1, 3, and 5 times rewards 1 intelligence kill. She also token awakens and should be able to feed into her physical counterpart. Rip my Elder Kai's I used on her. Clearing stage 7, 10 times rewards 8 Caulifla medals. Consuming 200 stamina between 315 and 45 gives 1 SSR, Elder Kai. Clearing all missions rewards 18 stones. Clear 5 stages with Battle Ethic Saiyan. Clear a Dokkan event and Z Awakening character. I'm not sure what those actually give you because it's not stated there. And we have daily missions. Clear daily missions for various rewards and 1 stone. Roshi event, Hercules event, story quest, and any stage 3 times. So there's a whole bunch there. That's what's going on. And that's all I could really talk to you about. And it also, really quick, the Jiren that's coming out, it looks like he's going to be part of the Realm of Gods category. So he's going to be on that team for those of you who wanted to know. Anyway, that's his Jiren right over here. Now, real quick, I'm not going to go into the cards. This is the new Caulifla. She is the Dokkan variant of the agility one that we currently have. She looks really awesome. She gets a new attack buff on her leader ability for HP attack and defense plus 70%. She still has the key plus 2, but it's all types HP attack and defense plus 70%. So that's freaking phenomenal. And you have Kale over here. She still does key plus 2, but she also does HP attack and defense plus 90% for physical types. So that's actually pretty damn awesome for those stat buffs. I mean, a lot of people, except for her, link very, very well together. So you're not going to really need to worry about that on a mono hero team if you're running that. Looks like Kefla is getting a Dokkan Waking. She now does Patara category key plus 3 HP attack and defense plus 150% up. So for those of you who are hating on her, you cannot hate anymore. That is phenomenal. Now, I don't know anything about their passive skills as of yet, so I'm going to talk about that in a minute. Well, not in a minute, in a different video. It looks like this is the new Jiren that we're getting, so I'm not going to go into him right now. Kaba gets a Dokkan Awakening, which is awesome. I can't really understand what's going on here. It looks like he has attack plus 80% up, but I will do a full one. This is the free-to-play Kaba, by the way, guys. So this is the one that you get, like, the Dokkan Awakens from this guy. So he will Dokkan Awaken into this guy, who now Dokkan Awakens into the ultra-rare, the TUR 120 Kaba. So I'm super hyped about that. It looks like this is going to be the farmable Caulifla that I was talking to you about. So you can go ahead, get her up to Super Attack 10. She Dokkan Awakens into the Super Saiyan Caulifla. I'm pretty sure she will feed into the agility one that I had just mentioned. We also have this Kale, who will Dokkan Awaken into this Brolic Beast over here. I'm pretty sure she feeds into the other Kale. Again, I'll go over that in a little bit later at a different point in time. And it looks like we are also getting the ability to Dokkan Awaken or into LR Vegito Blue. I don't know if that was already a thing or not on the JP side. I haven't really been paying attention. I'm pretty sure it's not because it says 322. That's when it's going to be released. Anyway, guys, that was a very long video, I know. Thank you for bearing with me on all that news and information. I just wanted to make sure you had all of it in one place. Plus, it didn't make sense for me to do a video like around like 8, 10, 11, 12 o'clock in the morning, at night for me, because I was already in the middle of doing other things. But anyway, guys, thank you for joining me here today. I hope that was really helpful for you. I hope that was really informative. I will keep you guys posted with all the card reviews. At some point, I'll be going over all of it. So anyway, thank you for joining me here today. It's been a pleasure. I'll talk to you all later. Peace.